rather uncoordinated and wore braces from the age of 13 until the day he died. However, in his all too brief life, he proved that he was a winner. On October 6, 1998, my son tried to show the world that he could win again. On October 12, 1998, my firstborn son and my hero lost. On October 12, 1998, my firstborn son and my hero died 50 days before his 22nd birthday. I keep wondering the same thing that I did when I first saw him in the hospital. What would he have become? How could he have changed his piece of the world to make it better? Matt officially died in a hospital in Fort Collins, Colorado. He actually died on the outskirts of Laramie, tied to a fence. You, Mr. McKinney, with your friend, Mr. Henderson, left him out there by himself. But he wasn't alone. There were his lifelong friends with him, friends that he had grown up with. You're probably wondering who these friends were. First, he had the beautiful night sky and the same stars and moon that we used to see through a telescope. Then, he had the daylight and the sun to shine on him. And through it all, he was breathing in the scent of the pines from the snowy range. He heard the wind, the ever-present wild wind for the last and he had one more friend with him. He had God. And I feel better knowing he wasn't alone. Matt's Eden, hospitalization and funeral focused worldwide attention on hate. Good is coming out of evil. People have said enough is enough. I miss my son. But I'm proud to be able to say that he is my son. Judy has been quoted as being against the death penalty. It has been stated that Matt was against the death penalty. Both of these statements are wrong. Matt believed that there were crimes and deeds that justified the death penalty. And I too believe in the death penalty. However, this is a time for growth, to show mercy to one who did not show any mercy. I am going to grant you life, Mr. McKinney. Every day that you celebrate Christmas, or a birthday, or the 4th of July, remember that Matthew isn't. Every day when you wake up in your cell, know that Matthew isn't. You took away something very precious from me, and I will never forgive you for that. May you have a long life, Mr. McKinney. May you thank Matthew.